Good evening, and thank you for being with us as we welcome the Lord Mayor of Westminster, Lord Mayor Duncan Sands, and delegates from the London New Year's Day Parade and Festival 2017 Committee, as well as members of the Royal Arms Drum and Bugle Corps based in Hoffman Estates. I'd like to acknowledge and welcome our village trustees, village clerk, and Illinois elected officials attending tonight. This evening marks a very special occasion for the Royal Heirs, as well as the village of Hoffman Estates. Indeed, we are honored to participate in the ceremony of the official presentation of the invitation for the Royal Heirs to join the London New Year's Day Parade and Festival next year. The Royal Heirs organization is steeped in tradition and is the only drum and bugle corps in Illinois which accepts members of all ages. They have worked tirelessly to provide quality entertainment while imparting a rich history of the drum and bugle corps experience. On behalf of the Village of Hoffman Estates, elected officials and staff, we are proud to have them represent our community at one of London's most prestigious affairs. Lord Mayor Duncan Sands, thank you again to your delegation for making the trip to Hoffman Estates to present this honor. I'd like to present you, Lord Mayor, with some gifts from Hoffman Estates, the key to the Village of Hoffman Estates, and other items. And
thank you.
We're very proud and privileged that you're able to be here today.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lord Mayor LeCloud, Duncan, distinguished guests, welcome and thank you for attending this evening. My name is Scott James, I'm President of the Royal Heirs Drum and Bugle Corps, and we're very pleased to have you present for this evening's presentation. Recently, the Royal Heirs received a very exciting inquiry from London that has resulted in this auspicious occasion. And without further delay, I'm extremely pleased to introduce the Executive Director of the London New Year's Day Parade and Festival, Mr. Robert Bone.
Well, what a welcome, Mr. Mayor, ladies and gentlemen, members of the Royal Heirs. Thank you very, very much indeed. I represent London's New Year's Day Parade and Festival. We call ourselves the greatest event in the greatest city in the world. We are an established tradition now in London, biggest event, annual event in London every year. We have, on average, taking part in the London Parade every year, 8,500 participants. 8,500 participants, drawn from approximately 20 countries around the world. Putting that in perspective, there is a somewhat arrogant city on the east coast of this country called New York. I know I can get away with saying that here, so it's fine. They have a little parade there every year on Thanksgiving Day. sponsored by a department store called Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. Just remember, we have 8,500 performers every year in London in our event, and Macy's struggles up to something just a little over 4,000. So the other thing about us is that we have a fabulous street audience. And it's all about the people on the streets of the city of Westminster, this event. It's for them, it's to entertain them, it's to help them welcome in the new year. 250,000 people came out onto the streets to watch it. 670,000 was our official audience this year. What they love are the exciting, dazzling bands and groups, particularly from the United States of America. That's the absolute truth. 300 million people around the world watched London's New Year's Day parade. We heard about you. You were recommended to us. And we were intrigued at the idea of having a group that was of all ages, from the really quite young to the, well, certainly not old, but latter middle age, shall we say. And we thought that would be something that would be unique and interesting to our audience. And so we heard your performances, and we thought, gosh, what a good idea. Wouldn't it be nice if they could come? Hence, we're here tonight, perhaps, to invite you to come to London. To be invited to the event, you have to be invited in person by a patron of the event. We're lucky in that we have one of the best Lord Mayors we've ever had in the city. I have to say that, butter him up a bit now. He's here with us tonight. He has got the power to invite you. So he's also going to tell you why London is the greatest city in the world. I'm going to set him that challenge right now. Would you please welcome Lord Mayor of the City of Westminster, Duncan. Thank you very much.
Well, good evening, and it's a great pleasure to be here at the village of Hoffman Estates. So I always say about the City of Westminster that when people say they are coming to London, what they really mean is that they're coming to the City of Westminster. And I say that because in Westminster we are the seat of the monarchy, the seat of Parliament, the seat of government. It's where most of the major museums and other cultural institutions are located. When tourists come to London, that's really where they spend probably about 90% of their time within the boundaries of the City of Westminster. And so the parade itself runs through streets that are full of history. The parade itself starts outside London's Ritz Hotel on Piccadilly. This is one of our finest hotels and one of our oldest hotels as well. And you travel down Piccadilly to Piccadilly Circus. And from there, you travel down Lower Regent Street and into Trafalgar Square. Now, Trafalgar Square has a big column with Lord Nelson on top. He was our great naval hero who won the Battle of Trafalgar in 1805. So from Trafalgar Square, you literally go onto Whitehall, which is literally the seat of government, where most of the government departments are located. And then as you go further down Whitehall, you pass Downing Street, which is has the house, 10 Downing Street, the official residence of the Prime Minister, and also the Cenotaph, which is our memorial to our war dead, before you enter into the finale arena. And the wonderful thing about the finale arena is that if you can imagine, you know, a fairly tight street in terms of its width, but absolutely packed to the rafters, probably 10 to 12 deep in terms of people watching. And, you know, you've performed all the way along the route, and this is just a wonderful finale for you before you head into Parliament Square itself, which, bounded by Westminster Abbey and Parliament itself and the Supreme Court, is a wonderful vista. The parade itself is a wonderful experience to have, but beyond that, the parade organization organizes for other cultural opportunities as well, an opportunity to see various places, but also just to feel that you're getting to know a part of England and London as well. And so it really is that once-in-a-lifetime opportunity that particularly for younger people can take and carry with them for the rest of their life. So, in recognition of an unparalleled reputation for outstanding performance abilities, the patrons and the organising committee of London's New Year's Day Parade and Festival, in association with Youth Music of the World, the City of Westminster, the Lieutenancy of Greater London, and the London Mayor's Association, take great pleasure in extending an invitation to the Royal Airs Drum and Bugle Corps, Illinois, USA, to participate in the 31st annual New Year's Day Parade and Festival to be held in London, England between December the 27th, 2016 and January the 3rd, 2017. Congratulations.
Thank you, Lord Mayor, for delivering that invitation. Did you accept it? It was a very significant year last year for our reigning monarch, Queen Elizabeth II. Everybody present know what happened last year? Queen Elizabeth II became the longest serving or the longest reigning monarch in the history of the United Kingdom. She overtook, not that it was ever a competition, but she overtook Queen Victoria last year. And to commemorate that fact, the palace caused to be produced some commemorative plates. And they look a little like this. And the Lord Mayor would like to present one to the Royal Heirs this evening. We have, don't go away yet, because we have very small personal gifts for you, which Rhonda is a brooch of the coat of arms of the City of Westminster, and for you, sir, the cufflinks of the City of Westminster. And Mr. Mayor, thank you very much indeed for your welcome here this evening, as I said, and we would like, or the Lord Mayor would like to present you with a set of cufflinks in the City of Westminster.
Well, thank you, Lord Mayor and Mr. Bone and the directors. We're honored to accept this invitation for such a prestigious event, and we will do our absolute best to confirm your faith in this to entertain the people of London. And thank you for your kind consideration of our organization, and I will make sure Rhonda carries that
umbrella
at all times. At this time, we've got a little something we would like to present.
Present you with this.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Our distinguished council members, chamber trustees, friends, neighbors here tonight, thank you for attending the presentation. We hope the Royal Heirs can count on your support to reach our financial goals.